TS is asking, you mentioned that when setting up the coilovers, that if the spring is preloaded, it is not a problem and will not affect the spring rate. What if it's the other way around and the spring isn't preloaded at all, it is loose on the shock until the weight of the car is applied? Yeah, that's, I'm really great, really grateful you brought that question up, because that's something that comes up a lot. So what Pierce is asking there is, I'll just reassemble everything here. So let's say you've got the spring platform wound down. So you've got, let's say for this particular, obviously like your ride height and your spring setup is determined on the free length of your spring. It's also obviously on the rate of the spring. And there's all sorts of different combinations of when you go to buy an aftermarket spring or buy different rates of springs, you always get an option on the free length and on the rate itself. So depending on how that packages in your particular coilover, this is how you can end up in the situation that Pierce is talking about. So let's say you've got your ride height and your ride height set, you're happy with everything, the low amount, the ride height's perfect, you're happy with the position of your suspension travel, where you are on your travel at ride height, but you've got the situation where the spring's loose. That's quite a common situation. Now there are a couple of problems with that. One is, so let's say you're cornering and the inside wheel has got no load on it and it's off the ground or close to being off the ground. The problem with this being loose is that there's a huge amount of vibration and bumps and everything going on in the car, nothing's happening smoothly. There's the opportunity for the spring to actually jump up off its platform and get caught on another part of the platform. The problem with that is if it's sitting up on the edge of the platform like this and the car comes back down on the ground, the car will have a whole lot of preload, extra force put on that corner of the car, and at some point during the lap, you know, it could be straight away, it could happen later, it's gonna sit back down on its collar, on its platform, sorry. And at that point, you're gonna have a really unsettling force to the car, so you don't want that to happen. You want this to be sitting on, snugly on its platform the whole time. The other thing is, when this thing, if it can move around, it can be incredibly destructive to your damper as well. Particularly, most of these dampers are usually made of aluminium body. You've got a steel spring. When this thing is rubbing up and down against the damper body itself, it will very quickly chew out the damper and make a mess of it. It'll have to be replaced pretty quickly. So that's something you want to avoid. So the way we get around this is by using something called a helper spring. And I've actually got a prop behind me I'll grab. So this is what we call a helper spring. It's an incredibly soft spring. So whereas this spring here, there's no way I'd be able to compress that together myself. But this is just, you know, really trivially soft. And the purpose of a helper spring, and again, these are available from all sorts of different spring manufacturers in different free lengths, different rates, different diameters to suit your situation. We just use helper springs to keep the spring in place when we have the situation where we have an uncaptured spring like we do here. So the idea is there's a little locating collar that I don't have with me right now, but essentially it gets stacked on top of here, and there's a little collar that just keeps the springs aligned with each other so they can't move sideways with respect to each other. And the idea is that now you've got this new stack on your damper. And the purpose is here that it's so soft that when the car goes back down on the ground after you've done your setup, or when the car goes on the ground in general, it doesn't have any appreciable effect on the dynamics of the car, because it's so soft that it's compressed instantly under the car's weight. But the idea here is that it just locates the spring and just stops it rattling around, and means that it stops you having an uncaptured spring. So that's what we use helper springs for, is in that situation where you've got an uncaptured loose spring sitting on the coilover. So hopefully, Pierce, that answered your question, and helper springs is what you want to look for if you're going to solve that problem. If you like free stuff and you'd like to learn more about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel, then we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You're guaranteed to learn a lot, and you'll have a chance to ask questions which we'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so click the link to claim your spot.